Nigerian Senate has finally approved the federal government borrowing of 2016 to 2018 five-year plan after heated debate that ended up in a closed session. The loan, $22.7 billion, was sent in 2016, after which it was rejected by the 8th Assembly and represented in November 2019 to the present 9th Senate. The Senate, while approving the debt rolling plan, said no part of the fund would be allowed to be spent outside what it was appropriated for. Earlier, at the presentation of the report on the Committee on Local and Foreign Loan, chaired by Senator Clifford Odia, there was tension on the floor of the Senate following the insistence of the opposition senators to know the details of the $22.7 billion foreign loan request.
And after exhaustive deliberations and consultations, therefore, the committee hereby makes the following recommendation to the Senate for consideration and approval. That the Senate do approve the under-listed ongoing negotiation and external borrowing in the sum of $22,798,446,773 under the 2016-18 medium-term external borrowing rolling plan.
Minority Leader Tor, however, warned that going ahead in passing the multi-billion dollar loan request without the details will spell doom for the country.
You are putting us in a very impossible situation because you are telling us to pass even those things that we approve of. It's either we say no or we say yes. And we say that that is not the way that we do our debates here. We must look at each item and decide whether each item will go or not go. This is also about Nigeria. It has nothing to do with partisanship. Actually, if you want to talk about partisanship, some of our colleagues here have also complained that this is lopsided in one section of this country, and we didn't want to make an issue of it, and we didn't. So, Mr. President, I want to ask on behalf of all our colleagues here that we take this issue item by item, because we cannot just wholesale pass everything that comes. If we have to do that, then we don't need to sit here and debate anything.
I recognize you in almost all the two cases you raised your hands. The only one I denied you was when you came under 43. And under 25, our standing order 25H, I interpret the rules. My understanding was you are supposed to have at least intimated me of what you are going to say. And that was how I ruled. It was not any effort to muzzle you. So there is nothing wrong in voting against whatever you don't want. Nobody is saying you shouldn't do that. And if you have an explanation that will guide us, we have taken so much explanations from our colleagues that will guide us to process this report. So we don't have to degenerate it into partisanship. I think we have come a long way.
Senate leader Yaya Abdullahi take to the suggestion of Senator Gabriel Susan that Senate should go into the executive session for 15 minutes to endeavor to resolve the contending clauses causing confusion.
I would appeal to you to allow us to go to an executive session for 10 minutes before we come out. Because there are certain information, Mr. President. No, wait now. There are certain information, Mr. President, that I also have that will guide the House properly, especially as is related to the power sector, that I do not want to say it in the full glare of the press. And those are very important information. So if we take 10 minutes and come out, we tie down the knotty issues and come out and then do what we need to do. So, Mr. President, my appeal to you and the colleague is that let us take 10 minutes of executive session, because there are certain information. The committee in certain areas didn't get the information correctly. And if we pass it as it is, we either be passing under or over.
In view of a lot of the information that is required and some controversies that have arisen, you know, out of these issues, I move that we go into closed session of about 15 minutes so that we can sit down and talk to ourselves and come out to a resolution of some of the major, you know, issues that are involved.
Thank you, Mr. President. I so second. Order.
Those in favor that the Senate goes into closed session, say aye. Those against, say nay. The ayes have it.
The lawmakers, after a closed-door session which lasted for about 45 minutes, approved the two-item recommendation of the Committee on Local and Foreign Loans. In his conclusion remark, President of the Senate was of the opinion that the positive impact on the gross domestic product of the country, as is charged those that will utilize the loan to apply it maximally to the benefit of the generality of Nigerians.
Let me also emphasize here that we are going to follow very strictly how these funds are applied by the executive arm of government funding the projects. Our committees, we must be prepared to ensure that no single dollar or cent is spent on any other thing outside of what has been indicated here. And we pray that this loan will turn around the economy of Nigeria. It's our belief that this loan by itself will definitely have some positive influence on the GDP of this country. And therefore, we want to assure Nigerians that as a chamber of the National Assembly, we will be responsible. We will ensure to be always available to ensure that no funds approved here are utilized for something else or used in very uneconomic and unprudent manner. This is our responsibility, and we must ensure that we do that.
President of Nigerian Senate Ahmad Lawa has lamented that the temporary coronavirus isolation center in the nation's capital Abuja is not in good shape. He said this while addressing journalists after inspection of the facilities at the University of Abuja Teaching Hospital Gwagwalada. The president of the Senate further lamented that some of 620 million naira, which has been budgeted to set up the center, was yet to be released. According to him, nobody should be found wanting whether there are any cases of the coronavirus. He therefore described the situation as unacceptable, noting that the center has to be fixed within the fastest time possible.
Both the representatives of the Federal Ministry of Health, the Nigerian Center for Disease Control, the management of the University of Abuja Teaching Hospital are in high spirits, looking determined to discharge their mandate and obligations. But from our inspection here, the temporary isolation center is really not in good shape. It doesn't look ready to receive any patient. And I believe that this is something that we have to fix between today and tomorrow. We are in an emergency. Even if we don't have people who are affected, we shouldn't just rest on our oars. We have to do everything and anything possible to fix that temporary isolation center to be prepared and ready to receive anyone who falls sick in this respect. I am sad. We're indeed sad that of the 620 million naira that was supposed to be released to this place for fixing of everything here,
NCDC,
not a kobo has been released. We are going to get to across to the Minister of Finance and all the other authorities who have anything to do with this to release this money between today and tomorrow. Latest. We are in a situation that nobody should be found wanting. Everybody should be at the top of his game. There is no way that Nigeria, the largest economy in Africa, with a population of 200 million, and yet in the federal capital and the surrounding states, six of the North Central, you don't have one room that you can call an isolation center, where anyone who unfortunately falls into this crisis would be taken to. This is not acceptable.
Bavidi Luxury Hotel, the newest home away from home in the Nigerian hospitality industry. 10 minutes only from the local and international airports is the perfect spot for your relaxation whenever you are in Lagos. 24-hour non-stop electricity, cozy and colorful rooms, Wi-Fi internet connection, and flat-screen cable television. Bavidi Luxury Hotel, our exquisite restaurant and full bar are simply second to none in taste and style. Bavidi Luxury Hotel, we are located at the posh Serene neighborhood in the Ikeja Business District. Your satisfaction is our first concern, so we train our staff to be professional and personable. Bavidi Luxury Hotel, number 20 Moshood Abiola Crescent, Ikeja, Lagos. Telephone plus 234-1291-7929 plus 234-708-287-7512. Bavidi Luxury Hotel, the new home away from home.
A bill seeking to provide legal framework for the already established Nigerian Army University has passed the second reading on the floor of the Senate. The university, which is located in Biu, Borno State, following an approval of the Federal Executive Council in August 2018, has since commenced operation, running 39 programs and 5 faculties, and has matriculated 2,776 students so far. This development followed the consideration of the bill for an act to establish the Nigerian Army University Bill to make comprehensive provision for the management and the administration of the institution. Leading the debate, sponsors of the bill, Senator Ali Undume, Borno South, said the university will be the only university with 3 deputy vice chancellors in academic, administration, and military training. While speaking with journalists after the plenary, Senator Undume underscored the importance of the university.
This university, the Nigerian Army University, will provide the blend that is required. That's why it's the only university, for example, that will have 3 DVCs. One is DVC Academics, one, and then there is DVC Administration. That is what you normally know in the normal conventional university. But this university has DVC Military too. And that will now provide the civilians the academic atmosphere to learn academically and degrees, even higher degrees. So you don't have to be a soldier to be in that university. You have the option, that is one. Then secondly, all the universities in this country have now been tailored towards specifics. Well, specific in the sense that you hardly see somebody from Borno now in these days, attending University of Nsukka, because they compartmentalized universities into regions, into states, into catchment areas, and all that. But this particular university is for Nigeria. You can come from anywhere, and there's no issue of quota system, there's no issue of catchment area, there's no issue of race, religion, and all that. So that makes it a unifying place for all those that are interested in academics, especially with military flavor. And as I said in the lead debate, that it will provide the civilians the knowledge of the military software, hardware, and all that. And then it will provide the military also the academics mixture with the civilians. This is the main reason. And as I said, already 2,760 or thereabouts students have already been matriculated. They are about 1,000 and 16 or 60 in part one, and this in part two, and they are about 1,776 or so that are now in part two. So the university is already on ground. Academic activities have started. They have 5 faculties there, and there are 39 courses in place now. So the university is on ground. What the Senate, what the National Assembly is doing or trying to do now that it has passed through the second reading is to provide the legal framework that is constitutionally required for every institution like this that is established.
The Minister of Health, Dr. Osagie Ehanire, has said the Director General of the Nigerian Center for Disease Control, Chike Iyekwezu, has been quarantined for 14 days. Ehanire stated this when he appeared before the Senate leadership to provide an update on the activities of his ministry to curb the spread of coronavirus in the country. He told the Senate principal officers that the Director General was quarantined because he had just returned from China. He said the standard practice was for anyone coming into Nigeria to be quarantined for 14 days before mingling with other members of the public.